Did you know that captions can boost your video views by up to 40%, and that 80% of viewers are more likely to watch a full video when captions are included? Well, with Canva's new captions feature, adding those captions to your videos just got a whole lot easier and quicker. So whether you're creating for Instagram or TikTok or LinkedIn, adding captions doesn't just make your videos more accessible, it makes them more engaging. I promised you I would do a video as soon as this feature launched, so let's do this. So first, some really good news. Canva's captions feature is available to everyone, even if you're using a free account. The catch, well, if you're using it on a free account, you won't be able to use brand fonts to style your captions. So if you want to stay strictly on brand, you'll need Canva Pro. But it's not like Canva has a shortage of good fonts that you can use for your captions. It's also worth noting that the captions feature is currently available on video and social media design types, although later in this video I'll tell you why it doesn't actually matter if you're using another format or design type to start with. Also, captions already supports a pretty wide range of languages, including Arabic, Chinese, English, Spanish, French, and all the other ones that are listed on the screen right now. But if your preferred language isn't here yet, I would suggest you just be a little patient, because I'm pretty sure Canva will be adding more and more as they have to the rest of their translation tools. So let's jump into how to actually use this feature. We start off with, as I mentioned, a video or social media design. I'm just using a blank one. Then we upload the video that you want to use, and you can then insert it into that design. Once that's on the page, you go to the text tab on the left, and there is a new dynamic text section. And there you can just select captions. Then it will allow you to choose which video you want captions for, and you just hit the button that says generate captions. Now Canva will automatically transcribe the video and add a caption track to your design. And honestly, it's pretty impressive how quick it is. Now in my experiments so far, this tool has actually been really accurate in transcribing any audio. But the first thing that you obviously want to do is to check for accuracy. And you can do that by clicking on the caption, and then by clicking on this little caption icon in the menu bar that appears. Then you can just edit the text on the left-hand side and change anything that isn't quite right. And once your captions are accurate, you can edit and customize them. Now, for this caption track, you can adjust the font, the different font styles, the colors, the effects, the alignment, even the line and letter spacing, and any other sizes that work for your brand. You can pretty much format the caption like you would any other text box in Canva. So if you're already familiar with Canva, this is just a breeze to work with. There are a couple of things to note though. You can add an animation, but it only affects the first caption and it won't change the entry or exit animations for each individual caption. After that, they just appear timed to the audio. And that's one thing that I'd love to be able to do to get a little more creative by adding different animations for the text. Also, any formatting at all that you apply will carry through to all the caption boxes, whether you do it to the first or the last one. So you can't adjust the position of just one caption or change the size of just a couple of words. It's pretty much all or nothing. But those are pretty much the basics of how this tool works. But I am not basic, so I wanted to share a few ways to get a little more creative with these captions in different formats. Before I do that, I wanted to let you know about a new free resource that I've just launched. If, like me, you want to uplevel your social media game and want to create some more animated social videos, I've created a collection of 6 social video templates inspired by some of my past tutorials on YouTube, and also designed to give you just a range of options to play with. Now, I actually created these to use myself, but I figured that they would probably be of use to everyone, so I've made them available. Plus, I did get a little carried away. I created a free mini course specifically to accompany these templates to walk you through step by step every design, how to customize them for your brand, and also how to make the most of them in Canva. These are available now for free for you to download, and you can grab them by going to createdbywayne.com/realtemplates. And of course, the link is also in the description below this video. The response to them so far has genuinely been so awesome, and I really hope you find them and the mini course really helpful. Okay, so let's add a little style to our captions. If you're using a standard horizontal video format, like for YouTube, or for a video you've created for a training course, or a webinar recording, or even for Facebook videos in a horizontal format, we can keep it super simple, or we can get a little more creative. Plus, just as a little tip, if you have a presentation or some other design that you want to reuse and add captions to, you can just use Canva's resize tool and create a copy of that by converting it to a video format. And that way, the captions tool will be available for you to use, so you don't need to start from scratch. If we want to keep it simple, we can just bring in the video that we uploaded. You can just make it full screen, and then do some really nice things just by formatting the captions themselves. We can obviously change the background that's used in this effect. We can change the font. We could do pretty much anything that we want to and just make it work for our brand. You could even do something like going to elements and bringing in a shadow or this kind of gradient box behind it. That way, if you go to the actual effects, you could remove that background and you can then style it the way that you want using your own preferred fonts, and you can make that background box a little more transparent so that the text stands out and it's got a nice shadow on it, but it doesn't dominate quite so much like that background does. And then if you play through, you'll see that the text is there, the new font style, everything else. So you could get really creative with it, but you could also just keep it simple and elegant and make it work for your brand. Another interesting way to do that, especially using horizontal video, would be to use a frame. So here I've just used a frame and put the video in that. I've added rounded corners and a border color, and I've used one of those shadow elements again behind the frame. It's just a really nice way of making the video stand out without using the typical full screen video. And then of course, we leave space at the bottom, which is where our captions would go. We'll just move them down, and of course if we move any of them, it happens to all of them, and then again we will just reformat the text so that it works for us. Here I'm going to use my own brand font, and I'm going to keep it super simple just by changing the color, changing the size, and maybe changing the size of the actual box so that it's a little more centered. And if I want that to work, I'm going to have to change the line spacing too so that it's a little closer. And now if I hit play, you'll see that that's really simple, but they appear below that frame, and it just keeps it a little more interesting than the typical full screen with the captions over the video. Now lastly, because we can also do some interesting layouts and formatting with the captions, we could not use a full screen video, but we could actually trim the video in a frame. So here I've added the video in, and I've actually animated in a little name tag to put at the bottom of my video. Once again, this is just the uploaded video in a frame, and again, I've put a border and a little bit of a shadow behind it. And then what we could do is we could use the space on the left for the captions, which would give us more space to make more of a feature of the captions, and also create a more interesting layout than just the normal horizontal video. Once the caption's in, we just resize the actual text box, we can change the alignment, obviously change the size of the font itself, and then format it the way that we want it to look. And then we have a way more interesting use of the captions. They still used, but we created a bit of a feature of them rather than just having them as a bit of an afterthought at the bottom of a video. If we're using vertical video, we can do the same thing by putting a frame in. Here I've just put a frame over an iPad element that I found by searching for iPad in Canva's element library, and I'm then going to go to my uploads, my videos, and click and drag the video into that frame. When I click on it, I'm going to use the position tool and layers to move it behind that iPad frame so that it looks really good and like it's contained in there. And then of course, if we decide that we want to add captions in here, we can just format the captions and place them below that frame so that they have a place of their own, but it gives us a bit of space to work with the rest of this vertical video. We can even add in some branding so that we've got our logo or maybe a call to action at the bottom. And it's again just an interesting way of using video in this format rather than just having a full screen video. Another idea with vertical video would be to just use the captions track as text on screen, so you'd actually hide the video. Now, the way that you would do that would be to use that same uploaded video, bring it in to your design, and then use the captions tool as we have before. Make sure you've selected just that video and generate captions. Now, once the captions are generated, what you could do is go to the position and layers tool and you could actually move your video behind another layer. So for example, here I just have an image in this frame, and I've put the video behind there, but the captions track or layer is above that image, so I can still see it. Now I would just format those captions the way that I want them to look. That means that when I hit play, the captions will appear, but the video itself is actually behind that layer that just has an image in. Now, we don't have to use an image in there. We could actually bring in a video from Canva's video library. So now that B-roll would play, but the captions from the original video will appear over it. It would be a really great thing to do with quotes or an inspirational piece of audio, but this way you can use video and use the captions without having to actually have the video appearing on the screen. And you could even add other elements so that you could highlight certain words, for example. So if I typed in circle pencil in the elements library, I can just bring in this element and I can recolor it and put it around the word media to emphasize that. And then just like any other element, I could adjust the timing so that it only appears when the word media appears. And that way, when we hit play and play through this, you'll see that it just appears to circle that word when it appears, and then it disappears again, and we can add animation to that or any other formatting that we want. That way we can add graphics or anything else that we want with the captions, but hiding the actual video track behind an image or B-roll. And before you start experimenting with this tool, there are a few things to note and just a couple of limitations to keep in mind. First of all, I suggest that you only generate your captions once you are done with editing or trimming your actual video clips. Otherwise, if you do any trimming, it gets a little confused over the timings of the captions track. If you do find you need to cut a section of your video or something like that, use Canva's split tool rather than trimming by clicking and dragging the endpoints, because that's where it gets confused. But of course, if your captions do get a little out of whack, you can just delete the captions track and get it to retranscribe them, although you will then have to reapply your formatting that you've done. Another thing to note is that you don't have any real control over the timings of each individual caption. That kind of granular control isn't available yet, so you have to just use the sections and where it's broken it up the way that it is. But that's pretty much everything you need to know about Canva's captions feature. It is a really simple and free way to add captions to your videos and have a little fun with creating some style with those. Now please don't forget, if you want to up your social game, head to the link on the screen or below in the description, and you can grab those new free social video Canva templates that I mentioned earlier, and the free course that goes with them. And please drop a comment below and let me know what you think about this captions tool from Canva and whether you'll be using it. That's it, folks. Have a fabulous week, and I will see you next time.